Woohoo, I am going trick or treating. This is so exciting. This city looks pretty candy rich too. Yay, my first house. This is going to be fun. Trick or treat.
Ah, howdy. You must be new around here, ain't ya?
Yeah, I am just here trick or treating.
Okay. Then I guess that means I should tell you that people here don't really do the trick or treating thing. They just put the candy in chests outside their house, and then you can take from it.
Okay, sounds pretty neat. Woohoo, candy. Even more candy. This is the best day ever. Oh, look at these other kids trick or treating. It's so cute. With this many houses and this much candy, I'm definitely going to get and eat so much candy that my stomach is going to burst with sweets. Oh man, this is going to feel so yummy in my tummy. In my very accurate opinion, people in this town are very generous with candy on days like these, and they therefore do not deserve to be taken to North Korea by a parade of marching elephants. Speaking about marching elephants, the other day I met an elephant called March, and they really liked marching and dancing. It was a very surreal experience, and I hope I might one day be able to find March again and show them to you, and then we could all enjoy a marching and dancing elephant. I also know a beetle called Bet. Bet the beetle has become a pretty lit friend of mine, and one day I might do a video with her if enough people want it. And now that it's spooky time, I am also wondering what I should do as a 2-year anniversary and as a Christmas and a New Year special. I guess I kinda already know, and that you guys have to wait to find out. Also, this is not me taunting people for not having the same knowledge of my ideas as I have. It's just me maybe hinting at something. But you won't have to mind that, because it's just me being a little weird, just as I always am. I think this is the last house in the city. Hashtag excited. What, the chest is empty. What's going on, dude? The chest is empty.
Meet me at -128/80-110.
No, I'm not going to meet you at some stupid location. I'm here for the candy, not for some weird stupid stuff, so either you keep to the tradition or tell me to go away. You are not just going to do this and be listened to.
Meet me at -128/80-110.
Okay, I'm fine, that was weird. I will ask what the other dude is up to.
Meet me at -128/80-110.
Oh no, not you too. Can you please just do something that is not showing off or irritating people for no reason, please?
Meet me at -128/80-110.
No, this is getting spooky. I feel threatened. I will get out of here. I promise, okay? I need to get to safety before he can get me. OMG, this is the worst Halloween ever. Okay guys, so I think it's about time I headed home. Wish me luck, because I think I might need it. What are these weird things? I will kill them before they kill me. Ouch, everybody please send help, please I am dying, can I get to the water? Please, if I don't make it home alive, please tell my friends. Wow, that was weird. I don't think that was supposed to happen. Well, at least it was only a game and I can make another Halloween video. Oh god, no. Let me guess, you will keep bombarding me with these until I come to the location?
Yes.
What's going on here? Why did you even answer me? How could you answer me in here? What, where, why, what's going on? Okay, Homie Shark, take a deep breath. It's all going to be fine. I'll go to the location and all of this will stop. Let me just get my handy gear and I'll go. Wohoo, settling on an epic journey to get rid of an evil curse put on me. This makes the Legend of Zelda theme play in my head and that just makes me excited instead of scared. These monsters haven't realized who they are messing with. I am the epic Homie Shark, 60 million years old certified adventurer and time traveler. These monsters can do me nothing, and if whoever put this curse on me think they can do anything that can just make me consider anything, then they are messing with the wrong shark. Here we go. An adventure like this is sure going to turn out to be fun instead of scary, and that Jack-o'-lantern dude is nothing but a pumpkin who thinks he is spooky because he uses some evil magic that can be performed by a 3-year-old. I hope someone at some point writes a book about this adventure, then I can send it into the past when I find the time box, and then I can publish it and probably make some money. According to my coordinate checker, I am getting really close, like in that game where you specify how close someone is to something and they find it. I would be so close they could not explain it. This wolf is actually a tad of trouble, so I think I will get out of the way. Dang it, these monsters attack me right when I'm weakened. It's almost as if they knew all along. It seems like this pillar is the location, so I will try and walk into this mountain. It's showtime. It seems to be quite empty in here except for this switch. I wonder what would happen if I flicked it. Also, I can't get out, so I think I am left with no other choice than the switch. Nothing seems to be happening. Oh god, what is that? Jack-o'-lantern, I must fight them, but they are too many. I'll have to go down here or die. OMG, no. Where am I? All I remember is falling down that hole, and why are there these jack-o'-lanterns, and what is at the end of this tunnel? Well, only one way to find out. What, lava? No, wait, no, I can't die like this. What is going on? So you might be wondering how I got out of that. Well, that's a story for another day.